This is Vijay, chemistry lecturer from Ailabad Junior College. As you know, we have started our NEET series, so based on that we are discussing each and every chapter in detail, and also we are discussing few numericals based on the particular chapter. In that series, today we are going to discuss about unit 1, some basic concept, the same unit, NCERT solutions. Yes, let us go for the next question. So the next question, that is about calculate the amount of carbon dioxide that could be produced when 1 mole of carbon is burned in air. First category. Second one, 1 mole of carbon is burned in 16 gram of dioxygen. And third category, 2 moles of carbon are burned in 16 gram of dioxygen. Yes, first let us write this chemical equation, okay? Carbon reacting with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. During combustion, carbon is in the form of solid, oxygen in the form of gas, carbon dioxide in the form of gas. 1 mole of carbon reacting with 1 mole of oxygen to form 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Okay? Yes. Here the molecular mass is 32 gram, and here the molecular mass is, overall molecular mass is 44 gram. So as per the first question, see. 1 mole of carbon, which is burning with 1 mole of dioxygen to produce 1 mole of carbon dioxide. That is what the first question. 1 mole of carbon reacting with 1 mole of oxygen to form 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Okay. According to the second question, which is related to the limiting reagent. Okay. That is nothing but 16 gram of dioxygen, which is available, it will react with 0.5 mole of carbon to give 22 gram of carbon dioxide. Okay, very simple. That is 16 gram of dioxygen, that is this, 0.5 mole of carbon, this to give 22 gram of the carbon dioxide. So this is one of the limiting reactant. Yes, for the second question. Third question, according to this question, you see 16 gram of dioxygen, which is available, it is called the limiting reagent. That means 16 gram of dioxygen can combine with only 0.5 mole of carbon to give 22 gram of carbon dioxide. So this is what the overall chemical reaction for the given question. Okay, now let us go for the next question. The next question is, calculate the mass of sodium acetate, you know, CH3COONa, sodium acetate. The COO group is always said to be acetate group, okay, CH3COONa, right, which is required to make 500 ml of 0.375 molar aqueous solution. Molar mass of sodium acetate is given 82.0245 gram per mole. Let us find the mass of the sodium acetate. Okay, right. So first, whatever given in the question, let us write. That means 0.375 mole molar aqueous solution of sodium acetate. Okay, this is given in the question. 1000 ml. So 1000 ml of the solution of sodium acetate, which containing 1000 ml of aqueous solution of sodium acetate containing 0.375 moles of sodium acetate. So 1000 ml of the solution contain 0.375 mole of sodium acetate. That means number of moles present in 500 ml, let us find. For 500 ml, we are going to find. Therefore, number of moles present in 500 ml is equal to 0.375 moles divided by 1000 into 500. Simplifying this, so simplifying this we will get around 0.1875 mole. This is what the number of moles present in 500 ml. Okay, now molar mass of sodium acetate that is given in the question, molar mass of sodium acetate that is given in the question 82.0245 gram per mole, that is given. Okay, so molar mass of sodium acetate that is given. Required mass of the sodium acetate, required mass of the sodium acetate, how much it is required? So required mass of sodium acetate is equal to 82.245 into this value 0.1875 moles. So multiplying this we will get around 15.38 gram. So this is what the mass of sodium acetate which required to make 500 ml of 0.375 molar aqueous solution. So by this way we can find the answer, required mass of the sodium acetate. Okay, let us go for the next question. Okay, next question is, calculate the concentration of nitric acid in moles per liter in a sample which has a density 1.41 gram mole per liter and the mass percent of nitric acid in it being 69%. Okay, so in this question we are going to find the concentration of nitric acid in moles per liter. Okay, so whatever given in the question, let us see. Mass percent of the nitric acid that is given 69% and a density also given. Let us see how to solve this problem. Mass percent of nitric acid given in the sample HNO3 given in the sample 69%. Okay, now 100 gram of nitric acid which contains 69% of nitric acid by mass, that means molar mass of nitric acid, let us find. So 100 gram of HNO3 contain 69 gram of nitric acid by mass. Okay, now molar mass of the nitric acid, molar mass of the nitric acid, first let us write the formula HNO3. Molar mass, number of individual elements present in this, 3 are there, H, N and O3. Okay, so first hydrogen, that is 1 plus nitrogen, S, 14 plus oxygen, 3 into 16. So adding this all we get 1 plus 14 plus 48. So adding this all we will get 63 gram. Okay, overall molar mass of HNO3 63 gram HNO3 molar mass. Now number of moles in 69 gram of HNO3 that is equal to number of moles in 69 gram of HNO3 that is equal to 69 by 63. Number of moles present in 69 gram of HNO3 is equal to 69 by 63. Is nothing but molar mass of HNO3. Okay, so simplifying this we will get around 1.095 mole. Volume of 100 gram of HNO3 solution which contain, we are going to find the volume of 100 gram of HNO3 that contain. mass of the solution by density of the solution. We are going to find the volume. Okay, volume is equal to mass by density. We know the formula, density is equal to mass by volume. Okay, volume of 100 gram of the HNO3 which contain. So volume of 100 gram of HNO3 which contain mass by density. Mass of the solution by density of the solution. Mass of the solution, that is what? 100 gram. Just now we have discussed. 100 by density of the solution given in the question. 1.41 gram mole per liter. 1.41 gram mole per liter. Okay. So simplifying this, we will get around 70.92. This is given in ml. When you are going to write in liter, that can be written as 70.9 into 10 to the power of 3 liter, converting into liter. Okay. Now let us see the concentration of HNO3. Now we are going to find the concentration of HNO3, that is equal to number of mole, 1.095 mole divided by volume. We have got here 70.9 into 10 to the power of minus 3 liter. Simplifying this, we will get around 15.44 mole per liter. So concentration of HNO3, that is equal to mole by volume. Simplifying this, we will get 15.44 mole per liter. This is what actually, this is the concentration of nitric acid. So by this way we can solve this problem. Okay, concentration of HNO3, 15.44 mole per liter. Let us go for the next question. Okay, so the next question is, how much copper can be obtained from 100 gram of copper sulfate? How much copper can be obtained from 100 gram of copper sulfate? Let us see how to write this. Question number 7. CuSO4, copper sulfate. Okay. 1 mole of copper sulfate which contain 1 mole of copper. 1 mole of copper sulfate which contain 1 mole of copper, Cu. Okay. Now let us find the molar mass of copper sulfate. Molar mass of copper sulfate. So in this compound, how many elements are there? 3 elements are there: copper, sulfur, and oxygen. Okay, CuSO4. Let us find the molar mass. Okay. So copper, that is 63.5 molar mass, plus sulfur, that is 32 plus oxygen, that is 16 into 4 or 4 into 16. Now simplifying this, now adding all this, 63.5 plus 32 plus 4 into 16, that is 64.00 or 64. Okay. Adding this all, we will get 159.5 gram. 159.5 gram. This is what? The molar mass of copper sulfate. Okay. 159.5 gram of copper sulfate which contain how many copper? 63.5 gram of copper. That means 100 gram of copper sulfate will contain. Let us find. Okay. So 159.5 gram of CuSO4 contain how many copper? That is 63.5 gram of copper. That means 100 gram of copper contain, that is equal to, let us find, that is 63.5 into 100 divided by molar mass, 159.5 gram. Simplifying this, we will get around 39.81 gram. This is what actually the amount of copper that can be obtained from 100 gram of copper sulfate, CuSO4. So by this way, we can find the solution. Let us go for the next question. Okay, the next question, that is, determine the molecular formula of an oxide of iron in which the mass percent of iron and oxygen are 69.9 and 30.1 respectively. Given that the molar mass of the oxide is 159.69 gram per mole. This question is similar to the third question. Okay, let us see how to solve this. Eighth question. Mass percent of iron given in the question. Mass percent of iron, that is equal to 69.9% given in the question. Mass percent of oxygen, that is also given in the question. Mass percent of oxygen, that is 30.1%. Now, number of moles of iron present in the oxide. Number of moles of iron present in the oxide. Okay. So, that is equal to number of moles we are going to find. So, 69.9 by the molar mass of iron. That is what? 55.85. Similarly, number of moles of oxygen present in the oxide. Number of moles of oxygen present in the oxide are percentage divided by 31.1 divided by molar mass of oxygen, that is 16. Now, ratio of iron to the oxygen. Let us write the ratio. Simplifying this, we will get 1.25. Simplifying this, we will get 1.88. Let us see the simplest ratio. That is, just now we did the third problem similar to this one only. So, 1.25 is to 1.88. That can be written as like 1 is to 1.5. We have got the simplest ratio in a decimal form. Multiply with the whole number, that is 2 into 1 is to 2 into 1.5. That is nothing but 2 is to 3. So we have got the empirical formula. We know the empirical formula, then we can write Fe2O3. Fe is 2, iron is 2 and oxygen is 3. Fe2O3 is a empirical formula. Now, let us write the empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass is what? The number of element present in the compound. Empirical formula. Okay. So that means that empirical formula mass, that is nothing but 2 into for iron, that is 55.85 plus 3 into for oxygen, that is what? 16. This is what? The empirical formula mass. Okay. So the empirical formula mass is, we will get around 159.69. For finding the molecular formula, what we supposed to do? We are using the formula. Yes. So now we are going to find the molecular formula. So molecular formula, we have a formula. Therefore, N is equal to molecular formula. That is nothing but molar mass by the empirical formula mass. Molar mass by empirical formula mass. Yes, molar mass, that is 159.69 gram, and empirical formula mass, just now we have got, that is 159.7 gram. Okay, so simplifying this, we get approximately 0.999 gram. 0.999, that is very close to approximately 1. So by this way, we can solve this problem. Let us go for the next question. The next question is, calculate the atomic mass of chlorine using the following data. Here are few data given. Percentage of natural abundance and molar mass of the chlorine given. Okay, 75.77 molar mass, that is 34.9689, and 24.23 molar mass is given 36.9659. Let us see how to write. Okay, let us see the average atomic mass of the chlorine. Let us see for the two categories. The first category, average we are going to find. Okay, question number 9. The first category, percentage what is given now? That is 75.77 by 100 into molar mass, that is given 34.9689 atomic mass unit. Similarly, one more compound that is given now. So here 24.23 percentage and the molar mass that is given 36.9659 atomic mass unit. Simplifying this, we will get around 26.4959. Simplifying this, we will get around 8.9568. Okay. So adding these two, we will get the average atomic mass of the chlorine, that is 35.4527 U atomic mass unit. So by this way, we can solve this problem. Let us go for the next question. So the next question is, in 3 moles of ethane, calculate the following. Here are few questions asked. Number of moles of carbon atom, number of moles of hydrogen atom, number of molecules of the ethane. Okay. Question number 10. C2H6. Ethane. Okay. First we are going to find the number of moles of carbon atom. Okay. So 1 mole of C2H6 which contain number of carbon atom. How many carbons are there in this compound? 2. Okay, carbon atom. So that is 2 carbon atom. 1 mole of C2H6 which contain 2 moles of carbon atom. 2 moles of carbon atom. Okay. Number of moles of carbon atoms in 3 moles. That is number of moles of carbon atom in 3 moles. That is given in question. That is nothing but 2 into 3. 2 into 3 is 6. So, number of moles of carbon atom present in this condition are 6. By this way we can solve. Next question, you see number of moles of hydrogen atom we are going to find. This is first one in 10th. This is second one. Number of moles of hydrogen atom, let us find. One mole of C2H6 contain number of hydrogen. Here number of hydrogen are 6 moles of hydrogen atom. Yes, 6 moles of hydrogen atom. Then the number of moles of carbon atom, number of moles of carbon atom in 3 moles, that means nothing but 3 into 6, that is 18. So number of moles of hydrogen atoms for this condition is 18. Now third one, number of moles of ethane. Very simple, 1 mole of ethane, 1 mole of C2H6 which contain, okay, number of molecules for 1 mole of C2H6 is 6.023 in 10 to the power of 23. Avogadro number. Okay, that means in the question they are asking 3 moles of ethane. That means what? 3 into 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23, that is nothing but 18.069 into 10 to the power of 23. This is what? Number of 3 moles of ethane. 3 moles of ethane is 3 into 6.023 in 10 to the power of 23. 1 mole which contains 6.023 in 10 to the power of 23. So by this way we can solve this problem. Thank you, children.